What's going on? It's Glenn and Cameron. Here we go. We're going to do this again. This is day four, digital introductions, 20Xing your activity. Yesterday, we talked about revising the offer. Today, we're going to talk about 20X your activity and why this is so important. If you're not making a bunch of offers, you are not going to get the information that you need. When you start making offers, you need to keep records. You should say, well, let's start at the beginning. You need to have goals. Someone had mentioned, I believe it was Matthew Campbell, that was talking about 100 calls a day. You need to have a daily goal of offers. It can be 10 offers a day. It can be 20. It can be 30. It can be 40. You got to have that as a baseline. When you have your goals, then you have to keep records of what you're doing. Because if you don't keep records, you're just gonna kinda not know where you are. It's gonna kill your progress. Keep your records, have your goals. You gotta have that plus daily activity. And when I mean daily activity, you have to carve out a part of your day. That's all you're gonna do. You're not gonna do anything else. You're not gonna Facebook, you're not gonna Instagram, you're not gonna tweet. For 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours a day, you go hard on whatever you're doing. And it must be 5 to 7 days a week. Now, this is where it gets scary. After a month of doing that, then you push yourself to do 3 times this month. And the reason is, I don't care how bad you are at sales. I don't care if this is your first rodeo. If you put that much time and effort into something with the intention of becoming better, you will become better and you will do it much quicker. Because what you can literally do is compress a year of activity into 1 month or 2 months or 3 months and get the same kind of returns. Many folks just don't understand that because it's a lot of work. And this is one of the reasons that kids are able to start businesses, because they'll immerse themselves in the business. And that's all they'll do. Like these guys who are really good with video games, they play video games 10, 15, 20 hours a day. They have no choice but to be good. Now you need to do those same kind of things for your business, which many people struggle with because it's not sexy. It's not something that you can brag on. Well, if you got the right crowd, if you could say, like, I made 250 cold calls today. And then there are people who will talk mess about just like, why are you cold calling? Why aren't you using Facebook ads? And I'm going to really get into that in a minute because someone's going to say that. Everybody cannot be reached by Facebook. I know that's hard to believe, but I'll use myself. I have bought one thing off of Facebook in 8 or 9 years. One. And now I really don't look at a lot of ads and stuff because they don't pertain to me. But when you have a dedicated, singular pursuit of reaching people for whatever purpose you want, you're going to become good at it and you're going to be really successful. Now, your first week of doing this stuff should be assembling your target. One of the worst mistakes you can do is just to call everybody unless you have a product that, even if you did like broadcast marketing, where there's so many people in that niche that even if you just overshot, you're still going to make money to pay for your marketing. You're still going to make money to make a profit after selling everything. But certain niches, like if you're going after skateboarders, it makes no sense to go after everybody. Where do skateboarders hang out? What publications do they read? Better yet, start a skateboarding YouTube channel and then go to the forums and all. There's so many things you could do. But you want to like say, who is going to buy my service and who do I want to sell to? Then you need to spend like a week assembling that. I mean, it's going to take you some time because you've never done this before. Now, how do you assemble that? First thing is research. Go to Google. Put yourself in the position of the people you want to sell to. And what I mean by that, I'm a business owner. And when people pitch me, a lot of times they don't really act like they know what I need. You're business owners. You want to make money. You want to grow your business. What do you need? You need introductions. Then you need conversions, because you can't get conversions without introductions. And that's the thing. And one of the things that I'm doing with this course is giving you the granular detail that you need to go through this and start making money. Because someone will say, go cold call, right? What's cold calling? Cold calling encompasses media, it encompasses your phone, it encompasses Twitter, it encompasses Instagram, it encompasses direct messages on Facebook. There's so many things that go into that that I just, you know, just go cold call. That's insufficient. Now, once you've narrowed down your target, is set up your work area for efficiency. Dedicated areas for higher levels of productivity. You know, it's funny, I am using the table that I wrote my first book on. It's a folding table because we don't know what kind of furniture we're putting in here. It has created workspace that allows me to rapidly put together these training videos. What you want to do is create a workspace that allows you to rapidly, you know, DM. Maybe you need a new phone. Maybe you need some kind of hookup. Maybe, because I don't think there is a app for Instagram for iPad. I'm not sure, but don't quote me on that. There's a lot of things that you can do, make your business model more productive and more efficient. And you want a dedicated workspace. If you don't have an office or you're not in a situation, work with what you have, but work toward getting a dedicated office space, because your office space is going to increase your productivity 20x, 30x, because everything's set up. And this is how we work from the mental standpoint. When you can sit down and immediately go to work, you exponentially increase your gains. You have to set up your workspace, and that takes 5 to 10 minutes, right? Doesn't sound like a lot of time. You only have so much mental energy to make decisions. So you're using some of your precious mental energy on really useless tasks. Michael Gonzalez, I'm a trucker. What do you think is the best working for somebody or working for yourself? That's a question you have to answer for yourself. What do you want out of life? It's, you know, some people will make millions of dollars working for corporations. Some of these folks will never have their own business. It just really depends on what you want and what kind of life that you want. I started all this. I'll tell you the story why I started this. Years ago, I was working for this boutique furniture company. We sold office furniture. One morning, I go in and I hear this. Ken was an owner this weekend. He had a bunch of Mexicans on his pool. Then I walk in and the room got quiet like E.F. Hutton. The dude who was saying this was just hoggling it. And everybody, you know, all white dudes. I was the only black person there. And they turned red. You know, they were being racist. I was pissed off, but it was Monday morning, sales call. And it's the most money I've ever made in my life. So I was like, I had a choice. Stay here and be demeaned or move the fuck on. So it took me some time to devise a plan. And 6 months later, I was gone and I never had a job again. That was my opting out of the job force moment. But that happened to me. I don't know what you need or even if you should opt out of the job force. Cash from clutter. Plus you can write off your office and your taxes most of them. No, 100% of the time. The more space that you use, the more that you can write off of your taxes. Because it goes by percentage. But that's a good point. Cash from clutter. Now, with the 20X, you know, you've got your workspace. You've got your target. Now it is time to work. And I'm going to tell you, if you are not used to working, if you're not used to sitting down somewhere, and your mind's going to mess with you. When I sit down to write, like my phones are always on silent unless somebody's coming and I'm waiting for something. I take my sheet of paper and I will write for 30 minutes to an hour. Then I'll get up and take a break and I'll come back and I'll do that for 2 to 3 hours. I will not answer the phone. I will not get on Facebook. Just straight work. If you can dedicate 1 hour of day to straight work, you will get so much done. Then after you've done all of these things and you've acclimated yourself to working, because many people, they're not used to working like that. They're used to then go talk to Bill or go down to the hallway and get some snacks or something. But ass in the chair, working for 2 to 4 hours a day with just, you know, health breaks, not, you know, Facebook breaks, but just get up, walk, stretch your legs, things like that. Then once you get that down, you push yourself 20x it. You start playing games with yourself. Like, okay, yesterday I made 95 calls. I'm gonna try for 115 a day. You turn it into a competition with yourself. So if you beat yourself, you still win. Robert, when you say 20x your activity, I always love referring to it as stroking it out. And you're very right, time to work. You're very right, time to work. Yeah, because the thing is, if you really push yourself, you can get the data points that normally would happen in a year in a matter of weeks. Now, you don't have to keep this pace up, but you do need to put it in for a month to maybe 90 days. Because what's going to happen is you're going to get all this information, you're going to get all this feedback that you can use to make better offers, to create a better system for the things that you're doing. Do, like, let's take dating. And you can Google this if you don't believe me. The average guy approaches 2 to 5 women a year. So if you start approaching one woman per day, 5 times a week, not even weekends, you in 1 week, you in 1 month will be 4 times the average guy in just 1 month. Many people do not work. Many people do not apply themselves, and they just kind of pussyfoot around, and they consume hours, but they're not being efficient nor productive. When I was in outside sales, and it was easier for me because I came from Rent-A-Crate, and when I was doing the office furniture deal, I used to just sit there and bang out my calls in an hour. Boom, 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 boom. Then have like sticky notes all over the place, like if I didn't meet people. And then I would take stuff with me because it's like, okay, the assistant said he'd be in the office at 10:30. Big ass pink sticky note right on my, I had this day timer, and I have it like, open up my day timer, there it is. And I'll be out, oh, it's 10:29, let me call now, boom. You have to have systems because you will not just keep up with this stuff, and systems will make you more efficient. They definitely will. And we'll be talking about this more and more and more. I'm going to give you everything that you need to make good offers. Everything else that we're going to learn in digital introductions is nothing without creating a great offer. It will fall flat. You're not going to make any money. You're going to be very frustrated. If you're going to use your marketing on Craigslist, you need 5 to 10 Craigslist accounts, which is 5 to 10 different email accounts and phone numbers. So that can help you, because that was the thing that got me over. During upscale garage sale on Saturdays, I would like sometimes post ads 3, 4, 5 times during the garage sale, because once they come from the top, they lose exposure, they lose visibility, and then the calls and the looks and stuff would decrease. So I just kept refreshing everything. Then I would like delete the pictures, take new pictures because stuff had sold, push the stuff together, take more pictures, post it. I was at work. And like I said, when you're at work and you're really working, you're going to get results. You just are. This section is just about, what's up, Cody? This is just about your activity level. If you want ordinary results, and this course will do it for you. If you take an hour a day and you're consistently working 1 hour a day, 5 days a week, 4 weeks out the month, you will get results. It'll just take you longer. But if you start to 20X your activity, first, create a baseline. Baseline is figuring out who you want to talk to, working out your workspace, getting your targets together, and then getting started and build some, a tolerance. You know, it's like, okay, this is what I can do. I can do 2 hours before my mind turns to mush. Do that for a week or two, or maybe a month. Then once you've got that, okay, I'm gonna add 15 minutes. Or, you can go really big dog style and say, I'm gonna add another 2 hours. You just continually push yourself. Now, what this is called is progressive overload. When you go to the gym and you bench 225 and then a month later you're benching 250, that's progressive overload. You cannot bench 250 before you bench 225. Same thing with this stuff. I'll give you the methodology here. This course that I'm building to last forever, evergreen, because these fundamental principles of business don't change. Before you can sell something to someone, you need their attention. That's never going to change. Then once you get their attention, you need their trust. That's never going to change, ever. So this is being built that you can come back and refer to this course over and over and over again and still make your money. If you're on the email list, whenever I'm going to do one of these training streams, because what I'm doing is building a course, it's free, you show up. If you want the recorded versions, that's going to cost you. And that's what the link's before. So yeah, as soon as this is over, it's going to go private and it's coming down. Maintenance concern, you just can't like go. Today, I've really done not much of anything other than this live stream, and I'll talk to a client, then I'm going to do the editing, then I'm going to eat dinner, and I'm going to watch a movie. I really believe, I'm not just saying this to, scare you. I really believe recession's coming. I think Amazon's purchase of Whole Foods was the first recessionary pricing move. Whole Foods is a well-known brand. It's considered a luxury brand, but they bought it literally for pennies on the dollar because Whole Foods was in financial trouble. This is when you can come in and scoop up and get better deals. And I think that's where we're heading. On my other channel, I got one that called, I'm going to release that later. It's called Trump Fires Mueller because he's going to do it. And then some other stuff. You will see me across my channels, and you just go to another video because it's not on there, and you can subscribe to all the channels, and you're going to start to see me, July especially, start 20xing it across the whole platform, everything that I do. So you got to go gradual, because here's the thing. Years ago, I used to work for this organization called the Gallup Organization, you know, and they told us that talking on the phone for hours was something you had to acclimate yourself to. And I was just like, whatever. And after 2 hours, man, my voice was sore. I was just like tired. And I had to train up. And this is the thing, same thing with working. If you're not used to really working, you're going to have to build up yourself to that point because you haven't done it before. I will be back tomorrow. And thanks for coming out, sharing your Sunday with me. You guys have a great day.